to allow that little girl to run around and say silly things. It's vulgar for Marianne to go on picnics with people or for, you know, that's not, that, and she truly believed that. She was taught that. That narrow, rigid way to Fanny shows her breeding, her, makes her worthy. Right?
In terms of personal space, just with speaking, thinking about when Robert approaches the women for the first time.
The brother?
When he first speaks to Lucy and Eleanor, of being able to use space for when he got into you living in cottage, that moment, like how far, like what would...
Personal bubbles.
Personal bubbles, they're not so large as they are, say, in Restoration. It's hard because they're kind of what we think of as a dead space in stage work. Because a comfortable personal bubble, that would have been kind of, and that is often not nice on stage. So you kind of have to play with either an abnormal distance, which to the audience will look like distance, or you want to really break. And the one way you can get personal bubbles is the angle.
Yeah, right. Direct versus indirect is a really good way to show that.
That's a
much better because the silhouette is so slender that you don't get to invade that as visually clearly as in other periods where there's a bigger silhouette. Mm-hmm. So usually directness versus indirectness is a good way to show I'm infringing on your space or I'm coming over directly behind you versus I have a respectful like angle discourse with you.
Mm-hmm.
And that's often the way, too, to make that sort of dangerous, comfortable distance seem more interesting, is through the painting gap, right? Mm-hmm. Go ahead and obliquely instead of direct.
Because they're still protecting something versus someone who is aggressively pursuing it.
Because they wouldn't have sisters, would have invaded each other's personal space all the time. It was a great era for petting of sisters and girlfriends, right? Sit together, hold hands, look at each other's embroidery, brush each other's hair. I mean, you know, it was a very girl... We were affectionate. They didn't get affection from their parents usually, and they couldn't touch any men, so, we're just going to be affectionate with whoever we can. But yeah, it was a great girlfriend, sister.
I also wonder, too, like, when John comes to visit the sisters.
John's
the brother.
Dashwood.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You know, if there would be, if one of them would have a desire to sort of be like, oh, my brother, and he goes a little. You know,
he's been away from that, right?
Or if he would be, like his fan is not there, but just thinking.
But if it would, sibling, male, females.
Yeah, you could. It just depends on how, and that's a sort of a character thing you can decide, because it would depend on how closely you were raised.
And they're not really, there's a distance between them. So I think having that sort of like, we would expect them to be like, oh, I'm so happy to see you.
Because they're a unit and he is.
Yeah.
You know how Dickens, the family, they're very affectionate brothers and sisters because they're all raised together, like Cratchits and all those people. But if, this is as Fanny says, they're not your real sisters, right?
Right.
They're the half-sisters.
Right.
They're not your real sisters. So that would have been lovely. That would be a lovely opportunity, too, because they have been raised
together. And there's moments of misconnection of hands. I think it's a fun way to do that. Mm-hmm. Between male and female, if I think that, oh, my brother is finally come home, like, I might instinctively offer the hand, and maybe he's already in his bow or something. So
or you would even offer both. My brother, right?
He's like, oh, it's so good to
see. You end up in kind of a curse situation.
Yeah.
And Margaret's a great opportunity for Margaret to show, because she would actually hug people.
Because we were just talking about that, like with John Dashwood, for example, would be a lot more of that space, but as opposed to me and Edward,
it's once she has affection, she won a hugging, she won.
Okay,
so a minute for questions.
Yeah, any other questions?
Did I have a question about hands during dances?
I haven't seen the country dance, right? This is one of the few times you can have your hands in a waiting position if you're in lines waiting. Again, don't drop that energy down. Make sure that energy, we talk about that lift a little bit, I would say air into the armpits, right? Feels awkward to get used to it, right? But it's that lifted as opposed to, because the thing is about dropping them, you want to keep that lifted and ready. You shouldn't be standing so long. Men, it's fine to have one hand or even both hands, depending on the dance itself.
What you're proudest of, if it's about, my new dress, if it's about whatever jewelry I might have, I can still go through the dance like this because it wasn't an era where you had to hold your skirts or your shirts up.
And some women would sort of show their skirts or their neckline, wait that neckline, whatever you're thinking about showing. Or you wait in anticipation, I want to show the men in my life I love this dance, I'm so excited. Right.
A word on dancing, there is a Atlanta contra dance society in Decatur I so recommend going because they just have it in like the basement of the church, and you everything makes so much more sense about how these people know each other, fall in love, and judge each other when you do one of these contra dances. Because suddenly you're like, oh, I completely know that complete stranger just because of how much eye contact there is, or how much hand holding, or whether they've got sweaty palms, like all of this stuff that doesn't make as much sense when you're just reading it and like, really, they fell in love because they danced.
Or they're sloppy and they leave you hanging in the day. That's an interesting experience because people you would not think were going to be interesting or charming. I remember one guy who was really older than I was. But he was so amazing in that dance, and I was kind of lost trying to figure out the dance right. But when he would come toward me, I was just like, I love him.
Yeah.
He's fantastic. And you really understand those characters that Jane Austen shows as being awkward in the dance, because you have those people that can't do it. Oh, we're pulling you.
You're like,
in the wrong spot. You're like, ugh, loser.